was limited in both flexion and extension, and she was limited kind of in the mid-range of flexion. She wasn't even towards the end of flexion yet. So in that part of the range, I would do a straight glide on the of the tibia on the femur. And I would place the roll under the femur and just push into straight posterior glide to get my motion. Now, as she improves and as she approaches more the later parts of the range, then the glide has been taken up in the lateral facet. So then I can incorporate the medial rotation of the tibia that is conjunct with that. And so then I would place her up into that position and have my force go through the medial tibial condyle to induce that medial rotation of the tibia for my mobilizations, and just to be a little bit more effective at getting that. And again, so much of the time I see my therapist in the clinic doing technique, you know, just cranking on some of these patients or not working on them manually and just getting them up and saying, come on, kick that knee out. You gotta straighten that knee when you're walking, and just trying to, you know, say they have to actively do that. Well, if we haven't helped them regain some of that motion, then that'll be difficult. I've got patients up into the mid 90s. I have this little old lady that is 94 years old, and she has a pretty significant osteoarthritis of her knees. And it's kind of a, you know, she comes in for a few weeks just for a tune-up, and then is on her way. And then, you know, probably 4 or 5, 6 months later, back in, because that osteoarthritis gets to the real painful stage again. So then I can mobilize her and help diminish some of the symptoms for a while, get her more active again. So a lot of times it's just tune-ups that you're doing with some of these people. So that's for the flexion.